Let's be real, designing is hard. It can take ages to come up with a concept and find the right tool, learn how to use the tool, and then attempt to bring your idea to life. We know your struggles, and Printful's Design Maker is there to help you out. This time, I've invited one of the teammates involved in developing our Design Maker to give us a little bit of insight into the all-in-one app in this episode of Ask Printful. Hi, I'm Elisabetta from Printful. In this video, you'll find out what Printful's Design Maker is, see some of its coolest features in action, and learn about improvements made to help you create and sell custom apparel online. We have an expert joining us from Barcelona. Hi.
Hola, how are you doing? So yeah, I'm Vincent from Printful. I work at the design department, and I basically spend my time improving design features and Design Maker. And today I'm gonna help you through the main questions that our users have.
Awesome, so to start with the first question, what is Printful's Design Maker?
Right, so the Design Maker is the tool we offer our customers in order for them to preview their designs and to actually design what they have in their minds. They can either start from scratch and use our pre-made designs and clippers that we have, or maybe they come with an already made design and they just put it on top of a product and they preview how the product is gonna look.
Right, that actually sounds super advanced. What are the sort of major improvements to the tool that we've made over time? Because I know it's been such a long work in progress.
Right, so Design Maker is always improving. We're always trying to find new features for it, and we're always speaking to our users into what they want there. In 2021, we updated the experience, especially for mobile devices. Now you're able to actually design in the same way that you design on the desktop. As for specific features, the text feature, now it has a lot of customization options. You can make arches with text, you can change the color, add shadows, things like that. And then we have clip arts that are pre-made kind of designs that you can choose from, you can search, and our designers and illustrators are always updating that collection. With that too, you can do patterns for all of your products. And like in general, it offers a tool to start designing from scratch and go from zero to an actual design that you can reproduce in a product.
So in your kind of professional opinion and with your professional eye, how do you make designs that actually look good?
All right, so this is kind of a tricky question, because when you think of beautiful things, different people are gonna find different things looking good, especially when you're a business owner and you have a store that sells designs online. You're gonna want to find your audience and know them enough that you can recognize what they're looking for in a design. I think in order to do that, you need to speak with them, you need to be part of the community sometimes. To help with that, there's tools online like Pinterest or maybe Reddit communities, even Facebook groups that let you know a bit about your audience and what you're gonna want to look for.
So once you've settled on an actual aesthetic that you like and the audience that you have and how to mesh those two together, there is a whole other part of design that's so nebulous and obscure to me. That is the design process, especially putting your designs and your art on tangible products that are often 3D, that have curves and that are almost never going to be just flat and perfect. How do we make sure that things are visible in the mockup? How do we get the mockup images generated as close to real life as possible?
Right, so that's one of the points where as a designer, you need to be looking into the details. Design Maker, we built it in a way that you can trust it a lot with the colors that you see on screen. For instance, black t-shirts. We updated the Design Maker in order for the colors to be exactly true to what you're gonna get in a black t-shirt. If you have transparencies, gradients, and little details with a lot of colors, you need to research how those will get translated into printing, even like theoretically. And if you're not sure, you can always order a sample from us. It's a special price and you get some of them each month. And then you can make sure that what you're gonna get, it's what you're expecting.
So all of these things are super useful for design professionals and people who are just really, really good at that. But in our promotional materials, we mention a lot that Design Maker has thousands of free assets. How does the design team manage to create such an extensive asset library that's also ahead of trends and remains timeless to help our less experienced designers?
First of all, we have a great team of designers and illustrators that are always updating these clip arts and the quick designs that we have. We ask our users a lot, and yes, we follow trends generally, but what's more important for us is that our users tell us what they need. We do user interviews, we send them questionnaires with their responses. We get the trends that we should follow in order for them to have the designs that they want. Our designers, first of all, will have a lot of brainstorming sessions where they decide what kind of themes they're gonna design for and what kind of styles are they gonna put those themes into. And after that, they will start designing the actual clipboards. Then we test them out in the actual product. We gotta see how they perform when they're very small, how they perform when they're very, very big, in different colors, in different materials. And so the user can be sure that they're gonna work on their products too. When it comes to timelessness, I feel like that's a bit more on the technique that we use. We're trying for all these clippers to be simple in a good way, simple enough so they're customizable. You can change the color, you can add them together in a way that makes sense, and you can use them in different compositions. The reusability of these clippers is, I think, what makes them timeless. The fact that they're not very into one specific style very much, that also makes it so you can keep using it in the future.
Yeah, I guess I really didn't think about just how much testing has to go into it, because the size and the type of product really affects how a design's gonna look. What do we do to maintain a seamless user experience across desktop platforms, sort of bigger screens, to like mobile platforms?
We make sure that when we're designing something, like when I mentioned we build this mobile experience, that's something that goes through beta testing, that goes through user interviewing, and we are lucky to have a lot of users that are interested in actually giving us feedback on the new features that we're building. That gives us a lot of input into how we should be designing things, what are the expectations from our users. We're gonna have to be experimenting a lot with the features that we launch.
And with all these improvements that we're constantly doing to the Design Maker, do we have kind of like an idea of what the future is for the Design Maker?
I can tell you that the future plans include a lot of customization options for the users to be able to actually personalize the experience and personalize a lot on their designs and the products that they are pushing to their stores. Custom mockups or very specific clip arts and quick designs for smaller niches, that's something that we want to push, and that's where I think the future of Design Maker is gonna be.
So that sounds like a very exciting future. I guess before we go, we need to make sure that we've covered everything. So if our viewers have any questions, or maybe they have some requests for new features or new assets, where can they leave all of these things?
Yeah, so if you have any questions or even you want to share your experience with other Printfulers, we have the Printful Insiders Facebook group. There you can meet a lot of store owners and they help each other, and this is where actually we get most of our feedback. But if you have a specific feature request, something you're missing in the Printful platform, you can always go to the Printful feature request site, and there you can vote for the ideas that other users have, or just put up your ideas and we'll review it and try to make it happen.
All right, that sounds very cool. I will leave both of those things in the description. And you'll need to be a Printful user to access the feature page, but the Facebook group is available for anyone. All right, thank you, Vincent, for all of the valuable information you've shared with us.
Yeah, well, thanks for having me. I hope all the main questions from our users are covered now, and they're free to go into Design Maker and actually start designing and fulfill their products in a better way and more reliable for them.
Let's quickly sum things up. Printful's Design Maker is free, has thousands of free assets, helps you create custom designs for any product and production technique, whether it's embroidery, DTG, or sublimation printing, can create product mockups for your store, and has a dedicated team working on new features, meaning that it's being constantly updated to fit your needs. Now, all that's left is to try it out for yourself. The first link in this video's description will take you to the app's homepage, where you can test all the features our Design Maker has to offer. From there, you can order a unique custom product for yourself, or sign up and start selling with Printful. Once you've made the first step, why not go all the way? One last thing. While our team is putting together the next Ask Printful episodes, you can help us out by suggesting new topics for future episodes down in the comments. Deal? All right, I'll leave you to it then. Thanks for watching.